So just to give you a little bit of background in terms of the needs, probably a pretty standard use case for Guru. Obviously, we had a ton of documentation, methodology, and stuff sort of scattered around in various sites, mostly Google sites, which houses most of this information. And before Guru, if you needed to find some of this information, really like what you do is you'd spend time like on Slack trying to find the right person. Once you find the right person, like then they'll kind of track down the information for you. So it's really sort of like taking a lot of time to find this information. And once you actually find this information, it wasn't really clear if these things were up to date or not. So and then this was sort of our main use case for why we really needed a tool like Guru. And then we started working with Ethan on getting, sort of all of our content structured. So what we did was we basically pulled team members from each of our different groups here. So we have, the business intelligence team, technical consultants, business consultants, solution consultants, project managers, and also the training team. So bringing all those team members together to kind of figure out like what is all the content that they need and what kind of, privileges and access do we need to all for all that content. And what we figured out was there's a bunch of content that we have that's really like key for like everybody, most teams within the professional services. A lot of these projects that we manage in terms of implementations, like methodology and things like that, that type of content is shared between all of the different teams. But then we also have content that's just specific to, certain teams. So like onboarding, things of that nature. So, we work with Ethan to try to figure out, how can we best structure this content? And basically what we did was we created, one collection for professional services and kind of figured out how we would manage, the content creation and the verification for that. And then also all the team collections. And so we identified an owner for each of those collections. And then we created, just so it's sort of clear, because we kept it open in terms of who can create content, we created, and I'll just show you an example, this card basically, which is a guide. And we created one of these for each of our collections. So this way, it's super clear of, what type of content we're creating within that collection and how we're structuring it. So talking about who can create the content, when should I create a card, talking about where it should live, and then we kind of give all the team members an idea of like who can author, who are the team leads, and sort of just like the overall structure. So I think this went a long way, especially when we were onboarding, to help people kind of understand that structure there. And let's see what else. And then so all of those owners that we identified within, sort of we call the, our pilot or beta phase, we kept that team intact, post our go live. And we have, biweekly meetings with all those team members just to make sure that, we're answering any questions in terms of like the structure and also making sure that we're keeping our trust scores up to date and kind of tracking down people that, that we need verifications on certain types of content. So just to wrap that up in terms of the results that we saw, post go live. So, I had a quick check-in with Ethan kind of looking at our numbers. So we had about a 90% adoption rate within the first 30 days, which was awesome. Obviously we were able to get a lot of our team members in there and active within the system. And then also our trust score was at 90% as well. So making sure that we're, keeping all that content up to date. So we're kind of working through and making sure that on a bi-weekly basis, we're keeping that stuff up to date. And so we've had a lot of positive feedback from all our team members. Everyone's loving the platform. And we have other groups within our company now that are pursuing Guru as well. So just wanted to thank, Ethan for all of his guidance and support on the rollout. It definitely helped a lot. So that's all I got.